Hello friends, how are you all? Trust all of us are well. It was very, very nice to receive a message where one of us had asked a question as to how do you make a classical North Indian dish which is made not only in every home but also in dhabas and restaurants, not only in India but across the world. It's a favorite, it's a classic favorite from North India. Yes, the dish is matar paneer, and the recipe of matar paneer now varies. I have seen three different recipes of matar paneer, but the one that I'm going to show you today is my favorite because the paneer in this recipe comes out very, very, very creamy. And it is an absolutely delight of a recipe. Very different from other versions of matar paneer. So, let's not waste any time. And let me show you what the recipe is like. So, follow me into the kitchen. Come. And now for the recipe, friends. The ingredients and the method of making, and I'm going to tell you this in details as to how to make it really very, very creamy matar paneer. This is the step number one, where you take the green peas, wash them once, twice, thrice so that there are no impurities, and then you add them to a cooker and we'll boil them. The water should be at least three times more than the amount of peas, or at least half a liter of water that I have taken now. Add a little bit of salt. As I always say, use natural salt, and cap the cooker and boil for 10 minutes or for one whistle. Well done. Remove and set it aside. Now for the second step, processing of green vegetables. We'll take ginger, we'll take garlic and chilies, ginger, tomatoes and onions, and nothing more is required other than these. So these are the vegetables that we will be taking and we'll be processing, and so these are the vegetables in totality once again. And for the spices, we'll take black peppercorns, 4, clove, 1, and cardamom, 1, and cumin, 1 teaspoon, and 2 bay leaves. And please don't change the ratio, otherwise the taste will change. Now, step number 3, we process the vegetables with the spices. Now for that, we once again turn on the heat. You can use a fry pan or a kadai, and I'm using melted homemade white butter, 30 ml that is. You can use clarified butter also. Punjabi dishes, as I always say, are best made with clarified butter. You can use either white butter or clarified butter. So I've taken 30 ml. Now getting ahead with the process, add the whole spices, let them sizzle, and well done. When completely done and well done, that is the time when we are going to add onions and green chilies. And as usual, we'll let them cook, and when they soften, we'll add ginger garlic along with that. And we'll cook, stir and cook, and when the onion softens, we'll add the tomato and we'll cook again. Now remember not to cover your fry pan or kadai, just stir, let the vegetables cook. When done, add natural salt again. Now no more natural salt after this is to be added. This is going to soften the vegetables also. And cumin powder, 1/4 CSP, and as I always say, don't change the ratio. Please don't change the ratio, and coriander powder. Please don't change the ratio of the ingredients. Otherwise, the taste will differ. And turmeric powder. And red chili. Red chili powder. Okay. So after you have added, we'll stir and we'll allow the vegetables to cook. When they are well done, soft and well done, but not mushy, we'll switch off the heat and allow the vegetables to cool down, because the next process is after they cool down. And done. Now let's blend the vegetables and make a paste. So we'll transfer it to a blender in batches or in whole. If you have a big blender, if it is a small blender, well, do it in batches and blend it to a fine paste. Now to make the creamy paneer. Now this is the most important step. How do you make your paneer creamy? So I've taken 250 grams of paneer, cut it into cubes, and not very big cubes, 1 inch by 1 inch max, and 1 inch. And again, white butter, that is what I have taken, and I am going to saute them. I am going to fry them, and in small batches, not together, because if I do it together, then it is likely that they will burn and not be done. So to avoid either of the two situations, I am going to do it one by one. Now this step is very, very crucial, because this makes your paneer very, very, very creamy. So you fry it in a manner that all the sides of the paneer are done and well fried, well sauteed. And we continue till the time all the batches and the entire paneer is fried. So a little bit of patience here is required. Now add them to cold water. Now this is the most important thing. Once the paneer is fried, add it to the cold water and let it remain there. This adding of the cold water produces the creaminess. So we set this aside till our next step. Now we start to combine the dish. Now how do we combine the dish? It's simple. Now again we turn on the heat, and you can again take on a kadai or a fry pan, whichever you are better with, and add the boiled peas along with the water that we had boiled the peas in it. Don't throw that water, because it has a lot of minerals and minerals in it. And this, lot of people throw this water and they use fresh water. Don't. Now add the vegetable paste. And now remember, both being hot, so it is better for us. It cooks early and the gravy is done. Cook till the time the gravy is really well done, and add the paneer. Now add the paneer and mix. Look how thick the gravy is, and look at the paneer. Leave the paneer there and add 2 red chilies. And as you saw, I have used fresh red chilies, not sun-dried. Now allow the paneer to soak the flavors of the gravy. Now this is very important. It takes a little time, a few minutes. Add fresh green coriander, so that coriander can release the iron and natural minerals in it, and allow them to infuse. And matar paneer is ready. Yes, it's ready. Look how creamy it is now. And you can serve this matar paneer with roti, naan, paratha, kulcha, puri, bhatura, rice, pulao, anything of your choice. And enjoy with all your known, unknown, near, dear, loved, hated, relatives, relations, scared, adored, friends and foes, and above all, your enemies too. That is most important. So friends, how did you like the recipe? Trust, you really loved it, and you are really wanting to make it today itself. Please do. Definitely do. And then do share with everybody. And as I always say, to live healthy, cook healthy, and
eat healthy.